The movement dimension tracks the components of the current period closing balance for your accounts and organizes your movement data to support cash flow reporting. The closing balance hierarchy calculates the current period closing balance from the opening balance and current period movements. The cash flow and cash change hierarchies organize and format your data to support indirect cash flow reports. Let's start with the closing balance hierarchy. Opening balance for balance sheet accounts is copied from the prior period closing balance when you run the consolidate business rule. In periodic view, the balance is copied from the closing balance for the prior period, in quarterly view from the prior quarter, and in yearly view from the prior year. If needed, you can input or load an adjustment to the opening balance adjustment member. Total opening balance is aggregated from opening balance and opening balance adjustment. Note that an opening balance is not retrieved for income statement accounts. You load periodic movements for your accounts to the base level members of the movement subtotal hierarchy. Seated members are provided to organize your periodic movements into the standard groupings required for indirect cash flow report, with the top level parents operating, investment, and financing. Seated members have the prefix FCCS underscore MBMTS underscore. The seated level 0 members under movement subtotal are included as shared members in the cash flow hierarchy to support cash flow reporting. You can add user-defined members to the movement subtotal hierarchy as needed for your reporting purposes. I want to include information on prepaid expenses in my cash flow reports, so I've added the MVMTS underscore prepaid expenses member under the change in net assets parent. When you add user-defined members, you should omit the prefix FCCS underscore, which is reserved for seated members. Data storage should be set to never share. For non-historical balance sheet accounts, the value for parent currency is copied from the prior period closing balance, so it's presented at the prior period ending rate. By default, the movement members are translated at the current period average rate. Because closing balance for non-historical balance sheet accounts should be presented at the current period ending rate, the system-defined formulas in the total change due to foreign exchange hierarchy calculate the adjustment needed to bring closing balance to an ending rate translation. For historical accounts, closing balance is presented as the accumulation of the movements translation from period to period. No net foreign exchange adjustments are made to closing balances for historical accounts. Instead, adjustments are calculated and then transferred to a currency translation adjustment account. The closing balance member is aggregated from total opening balance, movement subtotal, and total change due to foreign exchange. Cash flow reports show the movement of cash into and out of your business over a period of time. They show your business's sources and uses of cash and the beginning and ending values for cash for the period. The cash flow and cash change hierarchies display the same movement data as the movement subtotal hierarchy, formatted as required for cash flow reporting. The cash flow hierarchy is used for the upper section of the indirect cash flow report and includes movement data for your non-cash accounts. Every seated level 0 movement member from the movement subtotal hierarchy is included as a shared member in the cash flow hierarchy. Notice that the consolidation operator is set to subtraction. A debit to a non-cash account typically represents a decrease in cash. For example, an increase in inventory or decrease in accounts payable, both debit entries, requires an expenditure or decrease of cash. For this reason, the sign is flipped for all the shared level 0 movement members added to the cash flow hierarchy in order to represent the cash impact of the changes in non-cash accounts. For each of the seated level 0 movement members in the cash flow hierarchy, there is a corresponding seated parent member with the same name, but with the prefix FCCS underscore cash flow underscore instead of FCCS underscore MVMTS underscore. You can edit the alias for these members as needed for your cash flow reports. When selecting members to include in cash flow forms or reports, you should select the FCCS underscore cash flow members and not the FCCS underscore MVMTS members beneath them. Data storage for these parent members is set to dynamic calc and the consolidation operator to addition. User-defined movement members that you've added to the movement subtotal hierarchy should be added as shared members to the cash flow hierarchy as well, in order to keep the report in balance. I added prepaid expenses to the movement subtotal hierarchy, so I need to add it as a shared member to the cash flow hierarchy as well. Prepaid expenses belongs in the adjustments to net assets section of the cash flow report, so I'll add a child to FCCS_cashflow_net asset. I'll name it cashflow_prepaid expenses. Because this is not a seeded member, I omit the FCCS_prefix. For alias, I enter the text I want to display in cash flow reports. I set the storage to dynamic calc and the consolidation operator to addition. Now I'll add MVMTS_prepaid expenses from the movement subtotal hierarchy as a shared member under cashflow prepaid expenses. I'll change its data storage to shared and consolidation operator to subtraction, since a prepaid expense represents an outflow of cash. The rest of its properties are read-only. I'll include the cashflow_prepaid expenses parent in my cashflow reports. One cashflow parent member should be created for each row required in the cashflow report. However, multiple movement members can be grouped under a single cashflow parent. The cash change hierarchy is used for the lower section of indirect cashflow reports. It shows the total opening balance for your cash accounts, the total closing balance, and the change in cash. For reporting in translated currencies, an adjustment is added. The upper section of the report is based on movements and is translated at average rate, while the net change in cash in the lower section is calculated from opening balance, translated at the prior period ending rate, and closing balance, translated at the current period ending rate. It must therefore be adjusted to reflect an average rate translation in order for the two sections to match. The cash change hierarchy consists of system-defined members and does not need to be configured. To learn more, visit docs.oracle.com.